Hello, everyone. My name is Wendy Myers. Welcome to the Live to 110 podcast. You can check this podcast and the video out and the transcript at livetoo110.com. Today, we're interviewing Jan Eisen. He works with VitaJuwel. That's a company that makes gem waters. They make these gem water bottles, and they have about 17 different flavors, so to speak, of gems that help to structure water and elicit different properties into the water. And I've been using one for about 6 months, and I really, really enjoy using it. I really can notice a difference in that the water is energized and structured, and I, of course, filter my water prior to drinking it, and really, really enjoy using it. So I wanted to have Jan on the podcast and to talk about structured water and the importance of that and how to use gem water to improve your health. But before we get into the show, I want you to go check out my book. It's called Limitless Energy on Amazon. And I wrote this book because I really want to help people get more energy and talk about different ways that they can improve their energy levels. And one of the ways to do that is with detoxification and detoxing metals that interfere in mitochondrial function. Our mitochondria make our body's energy. And there's a lot of different things that can interfere in their proper functioning, namely aluminum, arsenic, tin, and thallium toxicity, and cesium that's being unleashed into our environment from Fukushima is causing an epidemic of chronic fatigue in our society. And people will drink caffeine and take stimulants and eat sugar and do whatever they can to self-medicate their body in a desperation to get energy. But eventually, they're not able to do that anymore, and they venture into chronic fatigue syndrome. So I wrote this book for so many of you out there that are struggling with energy levels, and give a lot of different tips and tricks on how to detox these metals. Some of them are very, very simple things and inexpensive things that you can do at home. I also give suggestions for working with one of our mineral power practitioners, of course, if you have other types of metals that are causing various issues. Some metals require working with an experienced clinician to remove them. And I also talk about bioenergetics in the book, which is my new passion. And I talk about a program called Nest Health, which is a bioenergetic program that I've been using for the past year to improve my energy levels. And it's dramatically changed my life and my energy levels and my brain function and my outlook on life. And I couldn't be more thankful. And I'm so incredibly thankful that I found it. So I wanted to educate you guys about that as well. So that's all in my book, Limitless Energy, on Amazon. Our guest today is Jan Eisen on the podcast. He was born in southern Germany in 1977, and he studied law in Munich, Germany, and worked as an attorney for several years. Jan was extremely exhausted of fighting battles in the court system, understandably, and decided to change his life by joining the family business and helping to educate and promote the value of gem water. Jan came over to California in 2013, got married, and happily lives in the East Bay near San Francisco. You can learn more about Jan at VitaJuwel.com, VitaJuwel.com. Jan, thank you so much for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Why don't you tell the listeners a little about yourself and how you got into the health field?
Yeah, my name is Jan Eisen. I'm a member of the Eisen family, and we've been creating gem water accessories for quite some time now. My dad started this 10 years ago when he created something called the gemstone vial. And he was one of those guys to put crystals directly in the water to infuse water with energy to restructure water. It's just a very old, basic concept that a lot of people have been doing for hundreds, if not thousands of years. And at some point, he was just tired of cleaning the stones all the time and trying to find a healthy, hygienic way to actually prepare gem water. So he started doing that basically just for himself, some friends, and got involved with a lot of people that were just trying to just create a buzz about the value of water, how important water is and healthy water is. And he was creating more and more of those vials, actually also introducing them to a lot of interesting people, people who just know so much about the value of water. And over time, over the last 10 years, it's just been growing. So now we're just an international company. I personally started entering the company about 4 years ago. I've been a lawyer before that, so something totally different. At some point, I've just been tired of battling all the time, of just doing negative things, and I turned my life completely around and helped my dad distributing gem water accessories. And he was just asking me if I want to start that in the States, in the United States. And this is what I did. I thought about it for quite some time and took my wife. And now we're in California and introducing gem water for the last 4 years to the Americans.
So you had sent me this gem water vial. It's called VitaJuwel, and I
Right.
really, really like it. I can really feel the difference in the energy in the water when I drink it because I filter my water with a Purifex water filter, and
Right.
then I put it in this. And I have the it's called the Inner Purity, right?
Correct, yeah.
And it's aquamarine,
Yes.
and it's yeah, and so. It has those jewels in it, and I can really tell the difference in the energy level of the water. Like it just feels
Right.
more energized.
Yeah.
So I really, really like it. So tell us about what exactly is gem water, and why would you want to even put your water on gems?
Yeah. So first of all, I'm glad you like it. So, and what you just said is what almost all of our customers report. It's just something that you can feel. A lot of people ask me, how can you prove that it's working? And the easy answer it is you can actually taste the difference. It's actually not so much a change in the taste. It's more the texture of the water changes. It's something that you can actually feel in your mouth that it's ta tasting different. And what we've sent you, or what a friend of us has sent you, is what we call a gem water bottle. So it's the Via gem water bottle in a purity. It's the perfect way to enjoy water or gem water on the go. Just one part of our product line. And gem water in general, as I've been saying, is a very, very old concept. A lot of people, a lot of wise women and men in the Middle Ages and ancient times put crystals directly in water for many different purposes. So and they didn't even know the scientific background. So they didn't know how the stones, how gems, crystals work on water, but they realized it did something to their body. It helped them just to absorb more water. It helped them with different ailments. It just in their belief helped them even in healing purposes sometimes. So what they did, they put them directly in water, selecting and playing around with different combinations of stones. The one you have called inner purity has aquamarine in it. There is, in our portfolio, we have 17 different blends. And all of these blends are targeting certain attributes. So, for example, wellness, fitness, vitality. And all of these blends are actually based on that old ancient belief that stones change water. Water is a fascinating substance. It's just something that can be influenced by so many different ways. You just said that you filter your water. What is and filtering water is, from my perspective, a great thing to start enjoying water. The negative thing about filtering water is that almost all water filters, they physically absolutely clean your water, but what you get out of it is dead water. So what we're trying to do is energetically vitalize the water. We try to create healthy, fresh, pure, lively, vital water. That's what we try to do. And this is also the concept that has been evolving over the last, well, at least couple of hundred years. There's a pretty well-known healer in the Middle Ages called Hildegard of Bingen, and she wrote a lot of books about how to cure people with different kinds of stones. It's not only about putting or wearing necklaces of certain stones. This is something that a lot of people believe in can change your can just help you physically too. Our approach is using stones to create healthy water. And we actually didn't come up with the blends that we are using ourselves. We just consulted with a lot of very well-known authors, scientists, people who have been studying those old traditions over the last maybe 30 or 40 years. And those people have been helping, counseling us in creating those fascinating blends. The one you have, for example, the Inner Purity one, is said to help you with detoxifying your body, getting all the poisons out of your body, also mentally just resolving stress and relaxing you. So every blend that we have, every stone, works somehow different. And the basic principle is that everything in nature vibrates. Stones vibrate. Every stone has its own single, unique, sublime frequency that vibrates in. And those sublime, those very subtle frequencies, they change water. It's the same when you put water in a microwave, it's beginning to boil at some time. What's at work is vibrations. So water can be changed by vibrations. And the way we do it is using those stones, those gemstones, and helping the water regenerate itself and restructure itself with the stones. That's gem water.
Basically, the goal of the VitaJuwel is to structure the water. That's essentially
correct.
The goal. And so I, you know, in doing my bioenergetic program that I do with clients called Bioenergetic Power with Nest Health, I aim to, I got more and more interested in structured water. There was a woman at the Nest Health practitioner training that was talking a lot about water and structured water and the infaceuticals that people take, the energetic remedies on this program are made with structured water. Structured water holds information and can transmit information, and it holds information just like a computer chip. And so how you treat your water and regard your water is very, very important. And if you don't structure your water, when you drink water, it actually takes energy from your body because your body is in force to expend energy structuring it. And when our in our modern world, water is going through pipes for long distances, and we don't have that that energizing of water and that structuring of water. So it is very important after you filter water to restructure it. And this is an inexpensive way to do that. And so talk about structured water and its importance in or the importance of drinking structured water.
Yeah, water is the elixir of life. Water is just something that we consume, or should at least consume, a lot of every day, because we consist of 70%, 60 to 70% of water. So there's almost nothing more important to just do consciously than think about what we drink every day. And as I said before, water can be influenced in so many different ways. Informed, restructured. There's even half a dozen terms to describe water that has been, as I say, informed somehow. Our approach of doing it is just a very natural one. There's a lot of very good ways to restructure your water, a lot of man-made machines, a lot of different concepts to inform or restructure water. Our way of doing it is doing it the natural way. Just imagine a natural spring. Spring water running over rocks, running just over those natural stones and regenerating the water. So what's happening if water runs over rocks, over stones, isn't only that the water becomes clear, that the rocks, the stones regenerate the water physically, it's all about the information of the water. We had studies launched in Germany that showed that VitaJuwel, or the crystals that we use, actually help the water regenerate to the quality that original spring water has in an energetic way. So it's something that you can absolutely taste. It's something that you can measure. We have tests run that showed that a certain blend that we use actually makes the water more alkaline. And it's also, you might have seen those wonderful crystal pictures of water, of frozen water. There are scientists who are just taking photos of water to show, to just help people understand how water can be changed, to show a before and after effect. There are scientists who also believe that if you talk to water, if you put names on bottles with water, or use stones like we do with water, water can be changed, the structure of water can be changed. The most, as I said, the most impressive way of showing that is those crystals of water, of frozen water. And it's something that you can buy books about. Dr. Masaru Emoto wrote wonderful books about that concept. One of our friends, Michael Ginger, wrote a wonderful book about gem water. It's a lot on the internet. So structured water is a fascinating concept that, from my perspective, can be best received or perceived by reading and getting more information on those wonderful water crystals.
Yeah, so how do the gems affect the water through sealed glass? So if you look at if anyone watching the video, I have a picture here of the VitaJuwel. And usually you think like the crystals need to be directly touching the water to elicit a change or structure them. So how does the structuring happen when the gems are behind glass?
Yeah, that's a question that almost all of our customers ask, and that is something that has to do with the concept of energizing water. It's actually, most people think that if you put crystals or stones in the water, there's some physical effect going on that has to do with minerals. And that's not the case. It's all about vibrations. So when you put water, when you put crystals or gemstones directly in the water, the problem with that is over time they become greasy. You have to clean them. They get dull. And there's even something more that's even more dangerous going on. A lot of stones are releasing toxins to the water. A lot of stones contain heavy metals. So you have to be, if you are one of the kind that puts stones directly in the water, please read about the different physical properties of the stones that you use. Make yourself knowledgeable about what stones you use, and ask people who are well known about that, read books about it, because it can be dangerous. So and also a lot of stones that you buy in a beach shop maybe, or in a gift shop, they're usually polished or waxed. And that's just stuff that you don't want to have in your water. So what my dad did, and that was the invention that a lot of people praise him for, is creating a vessel to contain the stones without really stopping them to work. So he just partnered with Bohemian glass blowers. He found people who could help him creating something beautiful like the gemstone vial. What you have is a gem water bottle. Our first product that we started to use is this handmade gemstone vial, something that you would put in a pitcher of water that contains just that selection of precious stones that I was talking about, and does not stop the stones from working. As I said, it's not the minerals that work, it's the vibrations. And vibrations work like sun rays. If you look out of the window, sun rays and light will come through in a certain frequency. Same with stones. Stones work through or still work on the water through water, work on the water through glass. Glass is a natural substance. The best way to actually contain water or to touch water, to treat water with, is glass. So he just thought about the idea of creating those glass vessels, put the stones in it, and helping people to enjoy healthy gem water in an efficient way without having the negative effects of cleaning the stones, worrying about the quality of stones, about what the stones might even release to water. And this is what we started doing.
So there's a little, dome here, like the gemstones are inside this glass. So is that water that's inside the gemstones as well, or is that a different liquid?
It's a special liquid that we have come up with. It's mostly water, has some other components like alcohol, just a tiny bit, to keep the stones from getting mossy over the time. It's purely harmless, so it's a natural liquid that we use. We played around with the liquid a little bit, and it's, as I said, harmless, but working perfectly for releasing the positive effects of the stones.
I really love it. I really love the VitaJuwel. I've been, like I said, I've been using it for I guess about 6 months, And I really, really enjoyed it. I actually want to get a few different of the
Lens.
other gemstones. And
Right.
I just haven't gotten around to it, but I have to look at the other ones because some are like for fire and passion,
Right.
and other ones are for different things. So do you have like a list that you can read us of like the different stones and what
Right.
properties they have, the different gemstones?
Yeah, I can tell you about a couple of different gem blends that we use. The most widely known is most probably the wellness blend. Wellness, or at least what we have titled wellness has amethyst, rose quartz, and rock crystal. And that blend is our most popular one and the oldest one out there. So a lot of people who put crystals directly in the water use the wellness blend or a combination of rose quartz, amethyst, and clear quartz. That's also called rock crystal. So that's a blend that's very soothing, very calming, very relaxing, also balancing. That's actually also something that is the most general one. Most of our blends focus on something specific, but the wellness one is the one that has been used in the Middle Ages already, is very well known all over the world. We have, I think, almost hundreds of thousands of customers using that blend now, and we have had the best results with it. If you go over the list, we have a website. We have a lot of vendors selling our items all over the nation, bringing mortar stores also on the internet, and all of them have different blends that we use, we promote, and the most general one by far is wellness. So if you're unsure what to take, if you're not drawn to maybe a certain attribute, a certain color, a certain combination, you usually go pretty well with wellness.
Okay, great. And so can you use this with like coffee or tea? I mean, you said you had that little stir
Yeah.
that you can put in a pitcher, and they're really elegant looking and they're really beautiful looking. Can you put those in wine or other types of liquids?
The cool thing is that a lot of people believe our products to be jewelry for water. So what we're trying to do is not only make it just as a tool, working as a tool, what we also try to do is just making it or designing it in a visually pleasing way. So it's just something that you should like to use. It's not only a tool, it's also like jewelry for water. And what you just said, using it with wine or different liquids or different beverages, totally possible. So we have customers reporting that they use it with juices. That it takes away a little bit of the bite of the juice, makes it less acidic. We also had people preparing tea with it. So just infusing their gem water for about 7 minutes. That's usually as long as it takes to energize a pitcher with water. So use it or energize it for about 7 minutes and then using that water to prepare their own tea. That's something that it's absolutely fascinating. We even have a special tea blend that has been created with specialists in the Far East that just told us maybe use that or play around with this different blend, moss agate and clear quartz. It's what we use for tea. Also wine. We're basically water people, but we've been asked a couple of years ago, well, why don't you use amethyst with wine? And why amethyst? And they told us that people in ancient times, the old Greek, they used amethyst to create their vases and put wine in it. Amethyst is also actually a Greek word, stands for or translates to the non-intoxicable. So the ancient Greek thought that if you prepare wine with amethyst or make vases out of amethyst, put wine in it, that you can actually change the taste of the wine. And the fascinating thing is that it works. It's something that I can almost guarantee if you use any kind of blend that we have with wine, we have with amethyst and put it in wine, the wine will taste different. We have sommeliers tested. We have a vineyard owner tested. We have wineries tested. And all of them said, it's so amazing that the wine tastes different. So what we have is, of course, as I said, every blend with amethyst works. We also have a special wine decanter with a special wine vial. We also have something really small to put in a glass of wine with amethyst. So wine, we are water people, but we are drawn to wine also sometimes.
But you're
So
also wine people.
yes, we are wine people, at least a little bit. So it's really great what an amethyst can do to wine.
I'm a wine person too, but I only once a month. I'm a wine person once a month. So let's talk about so what ways are there to prepare gem water? So just tell us about the different ways to prepare gem water and any kind of tips or tricks that people may want to know when trying to prepare gem water.
Right. So, first of all, you should, and this is a question that I get a lot of times, think about what water you start with. What I tell people is, as I said, the first step of preparing water, a good water, healthy water, is neutralizing or filtering your water, because you never know what's in your water. And I know there's it's kind of controversial if you want to put fluoride in your water or not. I personally don't like fluoride in my water, so what I'm using is a reverse osmosis filter to basically 100% get clean and pure neutral water. And then the next step, there's different approaches. As I said, you could put water, you could put stones in water after you just get a little knowledge on what stones to use. If you feel that the stones you use are safe, but please, as I said, read a book about it. There's this great book that I always recommend, that I already mentioned briefly. It's called Gemwater. The author is Michael Ginger, who sadly passed away a couple of years ago. He's been, as I said, a big friend of the family. He's been the one who advised us on what stones to take and what not to do. He also talks about different ways to prepare gem water, much more sophisticated than I could ever do it. And there's different stones that you can use with different methods of preparing gem water. The one I told you about, the direct method of putting stones in water, is one of them. The other one is what we do, VitaJuwel, is without having the stones come in contact with the water, creating vessels that you put in a pitcher or in a bottle with water, the one that you just had, to prepare gem water hygienically and what we believe to be the most efficient way. One thing that you also showed is, I also have a bottle like this here. It's called the Five Elements Blend. Also a very popular one with five different stones, and following the ancient Chinese traditions of the five elements in your body. The fascinating thing about the bottle is, and that makes preparing and using gem water also a lot more efficiently, is you can take that bottom piece off, unscrew it, and change it for another one. This piece here comes off for cleaning purposes, contains the stones that we've been talking about, and it's basically gem water to go. So our concept of having a bottle to carry around to prevent people from using bottled water in plastic bottles, that's just so, I have no words to say it. It's just so bad for nature. It's just so terrible to use plastic bottles. If you think about all the waste, even if you recycle it, it's just something that's not sustainable. So, what we try to do is, on the one hand, creating tools to prepare that gem water that we've talked about, and also making it easy for the person to use it and easy to love it. So, what we believe our way of creating gem water to be the most efficient and the most beautiful way of doing it.
Yeah, and you can wash the glass bottle in the bottom in the dishwasher and sterile. That's how I like to sterilize it. And of course with non-chlorinated dishwasher soap, most of it
Just
has.
real quick, I'm sorry to interrupt you, Wendy.
Yes.
What you should do is use the wash the glass part in the dishwasher. The bottom piece is best washed by hand.
Okay, great. Perfect. Fantastic. Yes, and so it's good if you do wash this in the dishwasher, not the jewel part, but the glass part. Make sure you're using non-chlorinated, non-bleach dishwashing soap. Natural, not those toxic ones. And so let's talk a little bit about what you think is the most pressing health issue in the world today. It's something I like to ask all of my guests.
It's about consciousness. It's about something that is getting more and more popular. It's not only approaching the body in a singular way, not talking about what's coming out or the results or what you might see or feel in the end. What I feel is important is seeing the body as a whole, a holistic approach, not only something that treats the body from the outside, not just only touching points and pieces of the body, but seeing the body as a whole. That holistic homeopathic approach is something that should be promoted, should be made known to more and more people, to offer alternatives to just traditional or school medicine or pharmaceutical treatments, finding treatments that just touch all of the body and not just points of it. That's something that I feel is really, really important.
Yeah, I completely agree. And I use a Nest bioenergetic program to be able to affect change in my body's energy field, in my bioenergetics, because I'm trying to raise my consciousness as well. And I'm doing it in that way and trying to open myself up to, I don't know, almost like the energy of the universe, so to speak. And feeling more connected, the collective unconscious, and trying to improve myself emotionally as well as spiritually. And it's just been a wonderful journey for me in working with bioenergetics to elicit that change. But also drinking structured water is part of that as a way to energize my body and reduce energy expenditure in my body, having to use energy to structure water that I put in. Even if it's clean water, you still need to structure your water. So it's kind of like the next level. I know some people listening maybe just trying to work on their diet and trying to do like basic stuff for their health, but kind of, you know, put it on the list of things to do that you, and but this is also a great gift also to someone, that someone that's trying to work on their health. This is just a wonderful Christmas gift or birthday gift. The price point is really nice. So it's just a great gift to give to someone also.
Correct. Yeah, it's a wonderful gift for people who are looking for something unique, for something that you won't find in the next door Target or Safeway. It's just something that you do something good to a friend or a family member, and also you'll see the sparkle in their eyes. It's just something wonderful. That's one of the reasons why I love what I'm doing. It's spreading the message of valuable water, or the value of water, and also having people use something they love. It's usually something that is very easy to see when you walk around with a bottle like that. You will draw people who are interested in what you're doing. The funny thing is, even if you don't believe what the crystals do, they work. And that's just great. We have, as I said, so many people who believe it's just jewelry for water. It's a wonderful water bottle. And I always know, hey, you bought something that's going to help you. And that's awesome.
Yes. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show. And tell the listeners where they can find you and where they can get a VitaJuwel water bottle.
There are a lot of stores out there that carry our line, a lot of spas, gift stores. There's one easy way to find us. We have a website, vitajuwel.us, with a lot of information on it. If you want to, we'd love to get in contact with you. Shoot us an email, contact@vitajuwel.com, or just call us. We're at the West Coast in San Francisco. You'll find our number on the internet. So just give us a call. Let's chat a little bit, and we'd be happy to hear from you.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Jan. I really appreciate you coming on the show and spreading the word about structured water.
Thank you so much, Wendy, for having me.
And everyone, if you want to learn more about me, Wendy Myers, you can go to live2110.com. You can learn about my healing and detox program at mineralpower.com. And if you want to learn more about unblocking your energy and identifying your energetic blocks and do the bioenergetic program that I'm doing, you can go to unblockingenergy.com. Thank you so much for listening to the Live to 110 podcast. And if you like what what you heard today, please go on iTunes.com and leave us a review on iTunes. That helps me to help the most people possible. That helps people find me when they search for podcasts on iTunes. I'd appreciate so much. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you have an energetic day.